It's June 3rd, 2017. It's 7:09 a.m. I have to walk slowly because I don't have a brace on or anything wrapped around my knee. So if I twist it or bow anything slightly off, then I'll be in pain the rest of the day. So just bear with me a minute. Oh, yeah. One of my little walks over to the garden you see on all the videos. Oh gosh. See, now I'm getting a little nervous because everything is starting to come to be comfortable now. Got a nice swing over here we bought. Got two chairs and a table set out in the living room. We got a fire pit that we built over there. Put this table covered. Garden's coming up really, really nice. These peppers only been out here about 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 2 weeks, I'd say. But, you know, with the winds that we've had out here and the storms, those peppers are about 7 inches tall. There's five in the first row. These tomatoes generally look almost like that. That's a pepper plant, but that's about how thin the tomato plants generally look when we have them out here. These were all planted. Everything out in this garden is from seed. You see, that looks like we were at China Mart yesterday, I think it was. And the Bonnie's heirloom tomatoes look just like that right there. Very healthy. They're thick. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 tomato plants out here. The smallest one is right there. It's about 3 inches, 4 inches maybe tall. But it's thicker. I put the PROTOGROW from Heirloom Solutions. Or solutions from science, depending on how they wish to be referred to. One or the other, I thought they're both the same company, but either way, solutions from science or heirloom solutions. It's a liquid fertilizer, and I put that on all the plants out here. You can put it on the plant itself. They recommend it even sometimes. And then in the ground, because it's liquid, it goes in better and it absorbs better. But the tomatoes look really all good and healthy. Look at that, man. And I got space for 1, 2, 3, 4. Actually, 4, but I can put another tomato back here somewhere. 5. I've got these slats that were from my mom's swing after she passed away. We brought the swing here, but it rotted and fell apart. So I used these 2-inch slats, cut them in half. Now they're inch slats. Perfect for tomatoes. That's how it used to be in gardens back when I was a kid growing up. Now you got the shitty cheap bamboo sticks that you get from China Mart. We're having a problem again already with this, bugs right there. Oh, there was a bee. Oh, shoot, I didn't have done that. He was in the flower, a bee in the flower. This is a zucchini. Look how big that is, too. There's like about 6 or 7 zucchini down here. I'm going to pick some of these today. This is the size you get in the store. That's about 8 inches long right down there. There's two of them down there that size, but there's about 9 on this plant. This one here, too, we had those, bugs, what do you call them, squash bugs, and I got them yesterday with dishwashing liquid and water, and you kit that and it usually kills them off. There was like 4 on there, 2 of them like they were mating and another 2 on another seam, and I squirted them. I didn't see any right now, I just saw a bee, which I said mistakenly scared it off. Here's this plant here. I don't see any zucchini. We're usually where the flower's at, but like I said, looking from here, I'm zooming on those zucchinis, you can see them. Nice zucchinis there. One off to the left, you can't really see. It's in the dark shadow. And our broccoli over here. There's, I should get the name. It's on an earlier video, the broccoli. See, this is late, though. I put these out way late. This should have been put out, like, the end of February. At the end of February. So you got March, April, and then the early part of May, we should have heads. But we do have 4 in there already. I thought I saw some. We picked off the worms, right? That's why these leaves look so bad. We didn't realize it. They're real thin, fine worms that almost look like this right here. And you would not know it unless you just happen to look. And like I said, we never pay attention. We come over here and look and glad them off. But they've already damaged some of the leaves here. And I've looked on the back side of the leaves. Then we got the watermelon. I planted another seed, let's see, down there, I think. I don't think we did plant a seed, but we got a watermelon here, this watermelon here is the same as that watermelon there, and then that right there. I think that's a sugar baby in this one, and this one should be the Waltham, which is the long watermelons. The sugar baby is the round ones, of which we got a 19-pound watermelon from the sugar baby, the round ones. This is cantaloupe, right there, right there. And then there's, I think it might be honeydew, right there. See, and I believe it was this hole here. Here, that hole or that one there, we had planted the other two. This is two beans I put out here. These are the Tobias beans from Heirloom Solutions / Solutions from Science. Oh, these things like this I have all over the plastic because out here the wind, if you've ever seen any earlier videos, the winds out here are like the term winds from hell, because I'm waiting for this plastic to end up out in the middle of that cornfield out there. Monsanto corn, by the way. It's about 50 feet off of the garden here. But that's the Tobias beans. I planted those about 2 weeks ago. And they're up already. They're about 4 inches up above there and 3 inches on the one on the right. There's other stuff planted out here which I can't remember. That should be a couple okras. That's an okra right there. These will get so big they'll be like trees. Yeah. When the shit hits the fan, folks. Yeah, it's gonna be something else, I'll tell you what. There's a crossing right over in the back of that train. I can't really see it from here now. But anyway, let's finish this up. Here's another okra right there. I'm going to zoom it in a little bit like that so you can see them better. And just move the, pick up the camera and move it. There are three hummingbird feeders out here in the garden. Help bring over the hummingbirds. But there's your two watermelon right here. Like I said, it's just that one that's the same as this one here. Right there. And this is the cantaloupe or honeydew. Basically the same, but a little bit different. This is, the big giant bean, you know, it's about the size of a half dollar, purplish color, and that's growing okay. Black-eyed peas, these are another thing, they should go out in the end of February, because they usually grow around 70 degrees is best. Now, and the heat's going to start warming up here, it's going to be in the mid to upper 80s later in the week. Like I say, it should be 80 would be like the top temperature you want for peas especially. Now this is a navy bean, white bean, whatever you want to call it right here. There's two beans in each hole. You can see there are pods down there. Okay. And it should let them go until they dry out. Because if you want white beans, that's what you do. Otherwise, you pop them like that and you cook them like that. So now the main thing is to keep insects off these. We got domaceous earth out here. That's the white stuff you see all around the on the plastic. Domaceous earth. And I spray with dishwashing liquid and water. Like I say, no chemicals. We try not to put any chemicals. Well, we don't use any chemicals out here. All these are from seed. Okay, there's, see, this is the thing I hate right here. Let me see. See this leaf right here with the disease on it? Comes from these trees. When you got Monsanto, 300 acres surround you with Monsanto farm products, which is chemically engineered food, basically. It's not food. Food-like products. And then you get stuff like this, diseases from trees, and the leaves fall on your plant. I mean, it's just like, you know, it's a next to no-win situation. It's not a no-win situation. We'll still get food out of here. But it's very challenging. And this is the Tobias beans right here. I put two down there, and I put two down there. And I put two over there. I put six out here, Tobias. It's like a white or a navy bean also. So as those come forward, I might move these fences slightly. Let me back out. As the ones that are there, the white, the actual navy bean, white bean, as they come forward on those homemade fences I make, I'll use this one, which I use chicken wire for, these fences, and I might move them slightly over and maybe out this way. So everything will just be moved a little bit to the left on these fences that are further north. So that's the southern half of the garden. This is the northern half. Here's another hummingbird feeder. Now this is a Jackson Wonder Bean. It's got flowers on it. Like I said, now the butterflies and all that are going to start coming out too because the heat's getting here. That's a Jackson Wonder Bean. All right, focus there. That's a Jackson Wonder Bean. Look at the leaves on this though. Because again, these should come out when it's late February. I would actually plant the beans the same when I do the peas. Peas are always cooler temperature. So just put the beans out the same, let them grow. So as long as you keep picking them, they'll keep growing. But like I said, see how they're looking like they're getting too hot. This is the only thing I can say. I don't know. I'm not a horticulturist. I do plant a garden every year, but I don't know what the hell I'm doing. So, what's this first one? Mayflower bean. Look at that one. It's nice, huh? I believe there's two plants in there, two beans down there. And then look at these. Look at how small that is. That one. These are all looking so scraggly. And it's all the same. You know what I mean? So, let me go back up here this way. I believe that was supposed to be that giant half dollar size bean. It's like a purplish color. Yeah, come on. There we go. I've planted two before and nothing was growing. Now it's growing. This was Trail of Tears bean. And that's up to my chest right here. That's about 4.5 feet. And then I've got the good mother. These are good mother Stollard beans. You see how those are going pretty good. This one too. So, and then like I said, the white navy beans. White bean, northern bean, not navy bean. I don't know, maybe they call them navy bean, I'm not sure. But that's the garden out here as of June 3rd. So, I got Miss Lucy and CJ's resting places right here. So, got some nice flowers for them. Lucy's right here, that's my big girl. And that's her, that was her, one of her puppies that I kept. And she ended up with cancer soon after we had been here, which again, I'm just going to attribute it to the Monsanto bullshit, so, but anyway. And then Lucy Lou, she was getting diabetes. Wow, amazing how common it's becoming, all that crap. And then I've got my sunflower wall, which is not doing as good as I would hope, but it's going okay. Those are going to be those bushy torch sunflowers, the orange flowers that get the big monarch and big winged and monarch butterflies. Hummingbirds go to it. That's torch two. And then these are all like the yellow head, the regular traditional sunflowers that with the yellow head. That one down there, that's the torch. Regular. I think I have torch mixed in some places right down there. The thicker, wider leaves, like that one there, is torch. And then you can see the ones that are more sporadic looking, like a star, is the yellow. You see how it goes down like that, and it goes across the back. And the back is hardly growing. I don't understand this at all. I wanted that wall mainly because of all that Monsanto corn. And I just saw one of our many birds we have out here. We have bluebirds, we have that yellow, we have a couple different types of yellow birds out here. Focus. My battery is flashing too, so that shows you how shitty this Sony is. Got to use AA batteries. What a joke. I mean, they're rechargeable, but still, even when they're brand new, though, you'll make one video and then they'll start flashing after about 15 minutes. What a joke. Okay, so that's it. Nam myoho renge kyo, nam myoho renge kyo, nam myoho renge kyo.